have learned what what is pronoun and what is common noun, right? I am a teacher.
Yes, ma'am.
I am a teacher, right? Observe the word teacher. Teacher, yes, it is the name of a person, right? It is the name of a person given commonly to all the teacher. All the but my your English teacher's name is Sai Sweta, right? Sai Sweta, right? Your social teacher's name is Bharati, ma'am. Your science teacher's name is Geeta, ma'am. Your physics teacher's name is Rajita, ma'am. Right? But every teacher has their own personal. Here, the teacher is the word. Teacher is the name commonly given to all the teachers. All teachers are called as teachers, but everyone has their own particular name. Right? Here, I have given one example. Taj Mahal is the historical monument of India. Taj Mahal is a historical monument means historical building. Charitrika kattadam antaru in Telugu, right? Taj Mahal is the historical monument. Here, Taj Mahal is the only historical monument. There is no other monument with the name of Taj Mahal, right? It is the name of a particular monument, Taj Mahal, right? Whereas monument is a name commonly given to the all monuments, all historical buildings. Do you understand, Anna?
Yes, ma'am.
Chetushree is a student. Vasanta is a student of 8th class, right? Here, Chetushree is the name of a particular student. Chetushree is a student. Tanuka Vidyarthi. Student, it is a name given commonly to all the students. Right? All students are called as students. Right, Nana?
Here, yes, ma'am.
It is a mobile phone, which we use to make calls, right? To communicate with others.
Yes, ma'am.
All phones are called as phones itself. Phone is a name commonly given to this communicative device, right? So,
yes, ma'am.
Name of a particular person, name of a particular place, name of a particular thing, name of days of a week, and names of months of the year, and festivals, special festivals, celebrations, national festivals, and name of a people who lives in a particular country. These are called as proper nouns, right? These are called as proper nouns. In the previous class, I have given example, right? Let's see some examples regarding. Regarding proper nouns. Vasanta, you have missed the previous class, right? That is why I'm giving the examples for proper noun. Okay, let me share the screen, Nana. Let me share the screen. See here, ma. In the previous class, I have given you examples for the proper noun. Observe the underlined words, Nana. Let's see the first one. Geetanath is a good student. Just now I have given you an example. Chetushree. Vasanta is a student of 8th class. Geetanath is the name of a particular person, right? Whereas student is a name of a person given commonly to all the students, right? Here, coming to the next example. Amaravati is the capital of Andhra Pradesh, right? Here, observe the underlying words here. Amaravati, Andhra Pradesh. These are all the names of particular places. Here, capital is a name given to the all capitals of countries or states, right? So capital is a common noun here, and Amaravati, Andhra Pradesh are proper nouns. Coming to the next example, Taj Mahal is a historical monument of India, right? Taj Mahal, observe the underlined words, Taj Mahal, India. Taj Mahal, India. These are all, Taj Mahal is, it is the name of a particular monument. Whereas India is also the name of a particular country. Whereas monument, it is a name commonly given to all historical monuments. Right? Taj Mahal, India. These are all proper nouns, and monument is common. Because it is a common name given to all monuments. All monuments are called as monuments, right? Here, another example. We have Bloom class of English on Wednesday. Here, observe the underlined words. Here, Wednesday, it is the name of a particular day. No other day is called as Wednesday. Voice cut out, Nana. Maybe it is a network problem. Are you able to understand me, ma? Madam, voice
cut out, madam.
It may be due to bad weather, Nana, bad network problem.
Okay.
You don't need to worry, Nana. Zoom class is getting recorded. You can see this class.
Madam, voice resound us, madam. Voice resound us, madam.
Now, okay, ma. You can, if you have any inconvenience to listen to the class, you can watch this video in YouTube channel, Anna. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, observe this this example, Nana. We have Zoom class of English on Wednesday. And underlined word, other than underlined word. Wednesday is the name of a particular day. No other day is called as Wednesday. Only Wednesday is called as Wednesday. Wednesday. So it is the name of a particular day. All the days of a week are called as proper nouns. Underline the month, Nana, here, August. August 15th is observed as Independence Day. August 15th is celebrated as Independence Day. Here, observe the underlined word Independence Day as well as August. Here, Independence Day, it is a name of a particular national festival, right? No other day is celebrated as Independence Day. We don't have any other Independence Day with this, with the name of Independence Day, right? So, it is a unique festival. So it is the name of a particular national festival. All the special days like New Year, Christmas, Ganesh Chaturthi, AIDS Day, Water Day, Earth Day, Father's Day, Mother's Day, Friendship Day, special days. Special days and national festivals and festivals are all called as proper nouns. Because they are particular, they are unique. Okay? What lacking every lay one matter. So proper nouns. Chetushrilaga inka evarainu unnara leru kada? Chetushrilaga inka evarainu unnara leru kada? Chetushri is the only student with the name of Chetushri. Chetushri and the peru kala ammai Chetushri tappa mana class lo unnadi inka vere vallu evaru leru. Right, Nana? So, see here. Recently, I happened to meet a German. German means one who belonged to Germany. Germany is the name of a European country, Nana. It is also a country like our India. We are in which continent, Nana? We are in Asian continent, right? Our country, it is an Asian country. India is an Asian country. Whereas Germany is an European country. Recently, I happened to meet a German who is very good at horse. See a German. Underline, observe the underline. No, girl. మనుషు ఎవరైతే హూఎవర్ హ్యాస్ గుడ్ హార్ట్ ఎవరికైతే మంచి మనసు ఉందో వాళ్ళని ఏమంటాం మనం హూ వెరీ గుడ్ అట్ హార్ట్ హీ చేతుశ్రీ వసంత ఇస్ గుడ్ అట్ హార్ట్ లక్ష్మి ఇస్ వెరీ గుడ్ అట్ హార్ట్ ఫ్లడ్డర్ ఫిజ్ హియర్ ఆల్సో నేను ఒక జర్మనీ కలిసాను ఎవరైతే ఎవరికి మనసు అయితే మంచిదో ఎవరైతే మంచి అతను దట్ ఈస్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ సెంటెన్స్ మై తెలుగు ఓకే హియర్ persons, people who live in a particular country, the names of a people who live in a particular country, they are called as proper nouns. Here, I will show you some more examples, ma, regarding proper nouns. I have given you notes also. See here. These are all the names of the people, but names of Sima, Harry Potter, Santa Claus, Mahatma Gandhi, Uncle David, Aunt Diana, Babai, Babai, Mama in Telugu, we call Uncle, right? Atta, Pinni, we call in Telugu, in English we call Aunt. They are called as Aunt, Aunt Diana. Here, see here, Dr. Lee, Doctor. Professor Raj, Mrs. Tyler, Miss Park. These are all the names of a particular persons. Here also, days of a week, months of the year. These are also proper nouns. Here, see here, Nana. Here, these are all special days and celebrations. New Year, Mother's Day, Father's Day, Friendship Day, Independence Day, Valentine's Day, Labor Day, Ramzan. These are all the festivals. See here. These are all the names of famous places, buildings, monuments. These are also called as proper nouns. Examples, Big Ben, the Spin, Greenland, the Grand Canyon, the Sydney Opera House. These are all the famous places as well as monuments. Eiffel Tower, Golden Gate Bridge, the Great Wall of China, the Statue of Liberty, the Taj Mahal. Okay, these are all the famous monuments of the world, famous places of the world. Famous places, buildings, monuments are also called as proper nouns. Come here, just now I told you, names of people who live in a particular country are also called nouns. We are Indians because we belong to India. Manaki India, manam India ki chendina vallam kaabatti manam Indians. One who belong to Pakistan, they are called as Pakistans. The people who belong to China, they are called as Chinese. All the names of people who live in a particular country, they are also called as proper nouns. Name of a particular person, name of a particular places, buildings, monuments, days of the week, months, special days, festivals, celebrations, and names of people who live in a particular country. These are all called proper nouns. Okay. Coming to common nouns, just now I have told you name of people, things, places given commonly. Who belongs to a particular class is called common nouns. Here, see some examples. Ruler. Ruler means scale. Scale that we draw to draw the marginal lines in the paper, in your notebooks. Ruler. The other name of ruler is scale. Pens, crayons, pencils, books, dictionaries, courage, courage is not a common noun, Nana. It is abstract noun. It is given wrong. Chair, table, sofa, lamb. Loyalty is also, it is not a common noun. It is abstract noun. It is given wrongly here. Carpet, telephone, hammer. Hammer means sutta. So, axe. If you don't know the meaning of these words, if you don't know the meaning of these words, you refer dictionary for the meaning of these words, Nana, because we don't have much time to give meaning for each and every word. Okay? Laziness is also, it is not a common noun, Nana. Laziness is an abstract noun. It is given wrongly. Here, names of animals. Dog, puppy, cat. The baby dog is called as puppy. Baby cat is called as kitten. Baby cow is called as calf. It's eggs and kids. Kids of animals. Pillalu. Calf, horse. The baby horse is called fowl. The baby sheep is called lamb. Like that. All the names of animals are come under common nouns. Included young animals. These are all young animals. Okay? I have given you notes, Nana, already. You can go through it. Common nouns. Names of places. Bank, hotel, library, museum, mall, theater, hospital, airport, gas station, park, farm, zoo, factory, nursery, school, university, office, mosque, temple, shop, gym, post office. These are all the common nouns. Names of places. See here, names of people, singers, dancer, artist, photographer, all singers are called as singers, all dancers are called as dancers, but every singer has their own name. That name is called as proper noun, right? Teacher, doctor, every teacher is called as teacher, but every teacher has their own name. That particular name of a person is called as proper noun, okay? Teacher is a name commonly used for all the teachers, right? Doctor, it is a name commonly used for all the doctors, but every doctor has their own name, right? You are all students of 8th class, but every student of 8th class has their own name, like Lata, Chetu, Vasanta, so many, right? This is all about common noun and proper noun. These are all the things we have discussed in the previous class. And let's move on to the next topic. Okay. I will show some examples here. Observe these examples. See the first example. Ma, are you able to understand the class? Am I clear to you, children? Children?
Ma'am?
Are you able to understand my class? Am I going fast?
Yes, speed ma'am.
Level. What? Yes? Speed levels, Nana. Actually, I have already taught in the previous class. That is why I went fast. Okay, already me chepestanandi faradaga chepestanu to start new topic. Okay, here observe.
Madam, voice cut avutundi kada madam.
What, ma?
Voice cut avutundi, ma'am.
Voice cut avutunda? It's okay, Nana. Yes. You can watch this video. You can watch this video in our YouTube channel, Nana. You no need to worry. Because of a bad network, you may not having clear voice of me. Okay, Nana, see here. Indian army is very potential. Potential means powerful, having lots of energy. And ready to sacrifice. Sacrifice means tyagam cheyadam. Indian army is very potential and ready to sacrifice its life for the protection of our country. Here, see. Indian army. I think you all know about Indian Army. Indian Army will be in the borders of our country to protect us from our enemies. Right? Here, see. Observe the underlined word here. Army. Coming to the next one. While I am traveling on bus, I have seen a herd of cattle coming towards our bus. Nino bus lo travel chestu unte nino ka pashulu. Cattle means cow or bull. Avule da gedalani cattle antaru. Herd ante group. While I'm traveling on bus, I have seen a herd of cattle coming towards our bus. Nino bus lo travel chestunnappudu ఒక పశువుల గుంపు మా బస్ వైపు రావడం చూశాను. అబ్జర్వ్ ద అండర్లైన్ వర్డ్ నాన్న హియర్ హర్డ్ అ లార్జ్ ఫ్లాక్ ఆఫ్ బర్డ్స్ ఆర్ ఫ్లైయింగ్ ఇన్ ద స్కై. అ లార్జ్ ఫ్లాక్ ఆఫ్ బర్డ్స్ ఆర్ ఫ్లైయింగ్ ఇన్ ద స్కై. ఫ్లాక్ ఇన్ తెలుగు ఒక పెద్ద పక్షుల గుంపు ఆకాశంలో ఎగురుతుంది ఇన్ తెలుగు. I am afraid of going to market due to the massive crowd in this pandemic situation. Actually, pandemic means it is a disease which is spread throughout the country. Okay. Vyadhi desham mottam paakute danini pandemic antaramu. Idi pandemic situation kada situation ante paristhiti. Pandemic situation kada manam undedi ippudu. I have written this, I have given this example related to our present situation. Nowadays, people are very afraid of going out without masks due to corona. Here, I am afraid of going to market due to the massive and a large, big, in this pandemic situation. ఈ పాండమిక్ సిచ్యువేషన్ లో ఈ భయంకరమైన పరిస్థితిలో వ్యాధి ప్రబలించే పరిస్థితిలో నేను మార్కెట్ వెళ్ళడానికి చాలా భయపడుతున్నాను. అక్కడ క్రౌడ్ అంటే ఏంటి, గుంపు, గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ పీపుల్, మనుషుల గుంపును చూసి భయపడుతున్నాను అని దిస్ ఇస్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ సెంటెన్స్ ఇన్ తెలుగు. See, if you observe the underlined words, what is the underlined word in the last example? Crowd, right? What is the underlined word in the first example? Army. In the second example, herd. H-E-R-D, herd. In the third example, flock. F-L-O-C-K, flock. In the fourth example, crowd. These are all underlined words, right? Army. What is army? What is the meaning of army? Army means a group of soldiers, సైనికుల గుంపుని ఆర్మీ అంటారు కదా. హర్డ్ ఆఫ్ కటల్, హర్డ్ మీన్స్ గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ యానిమల్స్, గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ యానిమల్స్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ యాస్ హర్డ్. హియర్ ఫ్లాక్ ఆఫ్ బర్డ్స్, గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ బర్డ్స్, మీన్స్ ఫ్లాక్ మీన్స్ గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ బర్డ్స్, గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ బర్డ్స్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ యాస్ ఫ్లాక్, ఇస్ కాల్డ్ యాస్ ఫ్లాక్. క్రౌడ్, క్రౌడ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అ గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ పీపుల్. What is the meaning of crowd? People. Here you can see the underlined words are the names of groups. Gumpula yokka perlu anamata underline chesina words anni. Right? Army is a collection of soldiers. Herd is a collection of animals. Flock is a collection of birds. Crowd is a collection of people. Right? Like this. The names of group of people or things is called as collective nouns. ఇవి కూడా పేర్లే కదా, కానీ గుంపుల యొక్క పేర్లు. ఏ గుంపుల యొక్క పేరు, మనుషుల గుంపు లేదంటే థింగ్స్, ఏదైనా వస్తువులు, ఏదైనా థింగ్స్ గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ థింగ్స్ ఆర్ గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ నేమ్స్ ఆఫ్ గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ థింగ్స్, గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ collective nouns. Let's see some more examples for collective nouns. Here you can see some more examples for collective nouns. Let's see. Family is a group of family members. Right? Father, mother. Right? Team of players. In cricket we have team. Cricket players is called as cricket team. Right? Community means people in the society. Right? Choir, band, orchestra, audience, crew means this club of sports, committee of something, company, gang, Government, army, these are all other examples of collective nouns, ma. See here, words for, names of words for, group of people, animals, things are called as collective nouns. Here are some more examples, crowd. See, here are more collective nouns you can use for groups of people. Crowd of shoppers, company of actors. Actors, you all know. You can all the people who act in movies or serials, they are called as actors. Group of actors are called as company of actors. Class of school children, like you. Gang of thieves, thieves means longer. Panel of judges. In court, we can see judges. Telugu, what we call judges, name and our Telugu lo nyayavadulu antaru kada. Yes. Platoon of soldiers. Groups of soldiers are called as platoon. These are all the names for the groups of people. And these are all the names for group of animals. Group of cattle, group of cows are called as herd of cattle. Group of birds are called as flock of birds. Group of sheep is called as dog sheep. Bugle of geese. Geese means baglu nana. Okay? Pack of bulls, nakalu. Group of lions are called as pride of lions. Pod of dolphins. Dolphins, I think you all know. Are you aware of dolphins, ma'am? Have you seen dolphins at least in the movies or in any on TV? Have you watched dolphins? I think you all are aware of dolphins. Group of dolphins are called as pod of dolphins. A school of fish. Group of fish is called as school of fish. Share of the group name under school of fish under. A litter of puppies. Puppies means baby dogs. Baby dogs are called as puppies. If we have seen a group of puppies, we can say that a litter of puppies. A group of monkeys is called as troop of monkeys. A group of chickens. Group of chickens. Chickens means hens. One of bees. Bees, you all know, honey bees, right? Group of bees are called as swarm of bees. Mountains. Feet of sheep. They are called as feet of vehicles. Deck of cards. We play cards. The cards we play to the collection of tools is called as set of tools. A group of trees, string of beads, like this. Right, and that long a bar of chocolate, but we have bar in the form of bars తింటాం కదా చాక్లెట్ ని పీసెస్ ఎలా చేసుకున్న బాక్స్ బాక్స్ తింటాం కదా చాక్లెట్ ని
పట్టుకొని ఇట్లా అవుట్ చేస్తాం
లాంగ్ లూప్ లాంగ్ లూప్ ఆఫ్ బ్రెడ్ ఒక పెద్ద బ్రెడ్ పెద్ద బ్రెడ్ దాన్ని స్లైసెస్ లో కట్టేస్తారు కదా పెద్ద బ్రెడ్ ని ఏమంటాం లూప్ అంటాం అదే కట్ దెమ్ ఇన్ టు పీసెస్ దట్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ అ స్లైస్ ఆఫ్ బ్రెడ్ ఓకే హియర్ యు కెన్ సీ ఎ పీస్ ఆఫ్ చాక్లెట్ ఎ స్క్వేర్ ఆఫ్ చాక్లెట్ ఐ థింక్ యు ఆల్ లైక్ చాక్లెట్స్ రైట్ హియర్ పేపర్స్ paper this is a sheet of paper this is a piece of paper I am holding a piece of paper a piece of information information is samacharam I have a piece of information to share with all my friends nandaro information undi na friends ki share cheskodaniki so a piece of information okka anapadaniki a piece of information ani cheppali okay here a slice of cheese I have a slice of cheese telusu kada junnu have you watched the advertisement of amul cheese like that you can hear the song also amul milk advertisement amul cheese amul milk product advertisement cheese it is a milk product nana cheese it will be provided in a form of slices dwara manaku dorukutundi anamata slice of cheese a slice of cake we have with that cake into pieces right that pieces we how we serve a cake by right? in a form of slices roopamlo under this serve chesanga cake ela unte alane serve cheyam kada we got the cake into pieces especially during birthday parties right we cut the cake into pieces and that piece is called as a slice of cake a piece of chalk you all know chalk we just use the chalk to write on the board chalk pieces a piece of chalk usually I ask you do you have a piece of chalk like that I ask you in the beginning of the class regularly right if I don't get chalk to the class right a piece of advice that means I have a piece of advice I have a piece of advice to solve a problem na idu oka salaha undi any problem ni solve cheyadaniki so we not say a advice oka advice ante a advice ananukunte a piece of advice anali adu enda in english these are all the collective nouns ma what is a collective noun a name of collection of people animals things or called as collective nouns now could you give some more examples for collective nouns if it is there mere examples for the collective nouns ki collective nouns anna examples ivadi collective nouns ki ipude chepanga na I have given many examples for this the collective nouns chaala chaala examples ichanu chusi cheppandi oh god
కరెంట్ వచ్చింది అదే
మేడం వచ్చింది మేడం మేడం.